How much would you pay to go up Willunga Hill with Whitey?
In the car. Fair bit. Then I don't have to ride up it.
Another big day. Boys are going to have to work cut out for them. Got to keep it under control for the first 50k. But yeah, we've got to go for these bonus seconds. The last stages tomorrow. We know that's one bar margins, small margins. And yeah, we'll know tomorrow if everything's enough.
You guys are the Willunga barbecue guys.
Yes, we are.
Have you got the barbie ready?
We've got the barbie ready for tomorrow.
What's he getting served?
Well, usually we do steak and sausages, but we're thinking with the bushfires and everything, we might do the Bunnings special, just the sausage and bread, maybe.
Oh, yeah.
We'll check with Matt.
But we're going to check with Matt.
Well, over the last 7 years...
I think it's more like 10, we've never, but anyway.
You've never had what?
We've never had a bad feed.
Oh, good. Say prawns or something.
So, surprises.
I was thinking about it.
You can surprise us.
A Bunnings special.
Nothing's changed. We've got 16 seconds available today, and I'd be very happy if we took 16. But no, we'll go flat out to try to control the first two intermediate sprints in the first 50 kilometres, and then we're going to put a bit of heat on the final climb to try to get a reduced group sprint so Daryl doesn't have to sprint against the fastest guys here, which will then obviously aid our ability to get 10, 6 or 4 on the finish line.
Do you want to get a barbecue order in for Willunga tomorrow, mate?
Oh, I could do. Does that mean I get to sit in the car, though?
Yeah.
I'm all for that, mate. Don't worry about that. What would I have? Oh, a couple of sausages, maybe. Can't go wrong with a bit of filthy sausage, can you?
Yeah, buddy, guys. We're on target, guys. I'm at 10's our target for today. 2 down, 8 to go. Hey Cam, this feels like a road point score tour.
Where's
it? We should send Yatesy up the road, see what the reaction of the peloton is.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not sure Yatesy would be too down with that.
Towards the line, I think she'll be a big victory. If it is, because he gets to the line.
It was not easy. Look, we gave it our all today. The big boys did an awesome job to get Daryl 5 seconds, and we tried on the climb. We got the gap, but the bunch was just too strong in the end. But amazing team effort.
I'm really happy to be back in the ochre jersey. It's you never know if you're going to be back in it. So we've been fighting for this all week. You know, now we've given it our best shot for tomorrow. We've ticked all the boxes. We've given it our all. Lose or draw, we've put on the best race possible and given it everything.
Took control of the race there today. Some great success in the intermediate sprints. First one, Daryl got beaten by world champion Matt Pedersen to take 2 seconds. Won the next one. Some great lead outs from the boys. And then quite a dangerous series of events happened after that, with pretty heavy hitters going down the road. Lucas doing a lot of damage on the final climb, and unfortunately those guys got caught. Too many sprint teams and a couple of GC guys missed the break, and the guys were caught in the final kilometres, which was always going to be hard then for Daryl to back up and sprint against fresh sprinters. So we've got the jersey by 2 seconds. Is it going to be enough? That's the $1 million question. We'll find out tomorrow.
Does this remind you of when Tour of Britain finishes in Scarborough?
It does, yeah. And I just can't wait to jump in there.
The princess is walking. He's also an old maid.
Which do you prefer, old mate or princess?
Old mate. You need hair to be a princess.